development in the case involving a taxicab driver who was attacked by a City Hall inspector. Last week, we first showed you the video of Taxicab Bureau Inspector Ronnie Blake attacking cab driver Emmanuel Esterlin. The city dropped all charges against Esterlin after we aired that video. Now the cab driver wants criminal charges filed. WDSU I team reporter Travers Mackle live now at 5 with who the victim met with today. Travers?
Scott, Emmanuel Esterlin talked with officers in the French Quarter. As he says, what happened to him was an assault, and someone needs to face charges. Flanked by his attorney and other taxicab drivers, Emmanuel Esterlin walked into the 8th District Police Station on Royal Street and filed a formal criminal complaint.
I feel that there's a lack of justice for me.
Esterlin wants Taxicab Bureau Inspector Ronnie Blake arrested and charged.
Did Ronnie Blake assault you that day?
Yeah, definitely. There's no doubt about that.
1 week ago, the WDSUI team first aired this video of Blake attacking Esterlin. The incident happened last October in the French Quarter. You can see Blake on the right using pepper spray or another similar substance on Esterlin. Then Blake uses handcuffs to restrain him. The city said Blake's use of force was improper and suspended him about a month after the incident. Only after a court order was the video turned over by the city last week.
Do you think people were trying to sweep this under the rug?
Yeah, I firmly believe they were trying to sweep it under the rug. However, the true injustice of the matter is that Mr. Esterlin was a victim.
Last week, the city issued a statement saying Blake's actions were unacceptable. Now it will be up to the NOPD to decide if the suspended City Hall worker faces any criminal charges. Last November, French Quarter tour guide Wendy Bosma took similar action. She claimed another Taxicab Bureau inspector, Wilton Joyner, attacked her while she gave a walking tour. The city also suspended him, but only after Bosma filed a criminal complaint with the NOPD were charges actually brought.
Well, the only difference between this case and Wendy Bosma's case is that this crime was more severe. Wendy Bosma was a simple battery. There's no question about the fact that a dangerous weapon, pepper spray, was used against Mr. Esterlin.
The NOPD is now looking into the matter.
We're just asking for justice, and as we deserve it.
Like Esterlin, Wendy Bosma was also charged after her incident, but those charges were eventually dropped. Esterlin is currently working as a cab driver in the city of New Orleans. Scott?
Travers, thanks. The city says the use of pepper spray and handcuffs are no longer allowed for all Taxicab Bureau inspectors. Weather now.